What's up, YouTube? This is the first episode of my, I guess, road leading into Junior Nationals. Pretty rocky start because I am starting the prep pretty much injured again. I'm gonna pour my pre-wall, I'll give you the history of this injury. I think it was last December. I hurt my hamstring. I made a video about it, but I hurt my hamstring while squatting. I think it was like December 2nd, which is about 2 months ago. Tweaked my hamstring while squatting. It was like a slight strain. What was weird about that injury is that after that, like a week later, I could still squat like perfectly fine. I literally did 640 pounds for two a week after the injury. However, what I couldn't do with the injury is deadlift, conventional at all. And so I couldn't conventional deadlift to save my life. And we went to sumo for a while. And apparently it didn't affect sumo, so I was able to squat fine, and my hamstring wasn't hurting while sumoing. But last Monday, we decided to switch back to conventional because sumo just wasn't working out, and we were closing in on time on the competition, and we gotta get the ball rolling. And right as I worked up to like anything relatively heavy, like I think I went up to, right as I got to 500, my hamstring had like a sharp pain, and I was like, what is this? I haven't touched 500 on conventional since December. So this problem with my hamstring was probably still there all the way up till now, and the only thing that reactivated it was going conventional. And so that's extremely frustrating because now it like re-aggravated itself almost a week ago from today. But I'm really not sure about the outcome of today because I'm not sure if I'm gonna be able to squat or not. Like, now that I've reheard it. So today's probably gonna be frustrating, hopefully not. It is a primary day, and I'm like programmed to go to like 6:30 for a single, and I have singles this block, which makes it so much worse. I'm like programmed to, probably towards the end of this block, I was gonna hit like 700, hopefully I still can, but jeez. It's just really frustrating to have to deal with something like this for the second time, especially as we start prep. But what I'm lucky that didn't happen is like, dang. What I'm lucky we didn't do was wait till like a month before Junior Nationals and decide to switch back to conventional. And then I re-hurt myself a month out. So like, I'm glad that we did it now because Junior Nationals is May 17th. And right now it's February 16th. So we have plenty of time to get back in the swing of things and get the ball rolling again. This shouldn't affect my meat by any means, but it's just, no ice, stop on it. It's just frustrating to deal with, especially when you want to see these numbers, like mentally, you just want to see these numbers fly and move. At this time, especially in prep, you want to make sure your prep is going good so you feel good going to the meet. But I guess today we'll see how things are going. And we got bench today too, so bench is going to move regardless. Fingers crossed. Hopefully I don't jinx myself. So last time I didn't get with the physical therapist. This time I got with the physical therapist because I was like, there's no way this is gonna affect me going to this meet. So I got with the physical therapist and he got me doing some movements and stuff to help my hamstring heal up a little faster. And today we'll see if it has been helping. Hopefully it has. Well, sorry for the rant leading into the session. Now we'll get into the session. Now, I almost had to run back into the house to get a Rice Krispie because I forgot my Rice Krispie, but I swear I got these things like everywhere, like, bam. I was like, I'm pretty sure I got one on me, and I look in there and I was like, bam, I do got one on, and I'm pretty sure I got like two in my gym bag. Freak, did I forget my code? I'm
part. I didn't show all of it, but I literally warmed up for 30 minutes to just make sure that I'm healthy and good to go. My hamstring's healthy. Also, my upper body, made sure to warm up that because I'm super tight when I get underneath the squat rack. Especially, my upper body is so tight that every time I get under a squat rack without like stretching it or warming it up, it's just like almost impossible for me to squat properly. So we got all that done, and now we can finally put the bar on my back.
Hey, you gotta go lower.
What?
You need to go lower. Now? Yeah, I think about pooping.
So, then go.
I gotta stop.
Okay. .370 felt fine, but the last time I squatted and it felt pain, I was at 500. So when we throw this next red on, it'll kind of, if I don't feel pain, that means we should be good to go. But if I do, then I guess we're gonna have to just lower it, go down to my back offs and just hit my back offs for today. And then that'll be it. But fingers crossed for this next red. Zero pain. Didn't feel any pain, surprisingly. Zero pain. However, like, I tempoed it extremely slow, even on the concentric. On the way up, it was like super, super slow. I also didn't get deep enough. So I'm gonna go to my top set, 617, but I'm gonna get like a ton of spotters. And I feel like in the back of my head, I was kind of cautious with the 551, because I was like, if I fail, it's a wrap. Like, I'm done for. So, but with the 617, to make sure I have a bunch of spotters. So if anything does happen, if I feel a sharp pain, then I'm just gonna like say, yell, grab it. And then you're gonna grab it, but I'm getting depth on this one. It's gonna be slow, but I'm gonna make sure it's depth and make sure it's good. All right, let's get it. The funny thing was, when I went to go unrack it, it hit me pretty hard in my hamstring. And I was like, no, 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 no. But then when I got it out, I was like, okay, let's just go.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm gonna be brutally honest. Coming in today, I did not think that was gonna happen in the slightest. I thought that I was gonna feel the pain at 500 and just like completely get shut off from there. But that was not the case. We took 617 and we got it with like no pain. However, on the unrack, it was weird because on the unrack, like, I felt it hit me in the hamstring, and I was like, oh God, this is not promising. But since this time I had spotters, I was like, shoot, I'm gonna send it anyway. And perfect. I mean, like I said, we tempoed it like crazy, but we hit depth, and we completed the rep with zero pain. So huge W on the day, especially with how it's been going. So now we're just gonna take the back downs and honestly do the same thing. I'm gonna tempo them. Take the back downs, and then we got bench. But obviously hamstring hasn't affected the bench at all. So I'm gonna send the bench. It's like an RPE 7 at a single. We got singles this whole block, so it's gonna be exciting. So RPE 7 on a single, and honestly I'll see where I'm at, because he doesn't give me a cap on bench. It's more so just the RPE, so it's wherever I deem the top set should be. So I'm just gonna hit these back downs, and then we can move on to bench. I'm perfect. Vince is like the one lift out of all three that is doing really good right now. I learned a new way to wedge, which I'll show you here in a minute. Makes me able to unwreck myself pretty easily without wasting a lot of energy. Plus, it makes me a lot tighter.
Oh, we're loading something dumb today.
I'm loading something dumb today. Sean ain't gonna stop me. Yeah, I'll take commands. I'm gonna do my own lift off though. This is the most I've ever unwrecked myself.
Start. Press. Rack.
That was good. Dude, I felt like I could hold it there forever.
Where?
Yeah, Sean told me not to self unwrack anymore. Said it was inefficient. Three.
Start. Hold up. Press. Rack.
I wasn't recording on my phone. Screw me.
Let's go.
Yeah, that's pretty good. Okay, so bench went fairly well. There were some things that I had to fix, like my unrack was just inefficient. Even on the other sets, I start my rep way too far out from the bar. I need to get more underneath the bar when I unwrap. And I feel like that's an easy fix, so we'll fix that next time. But that concludes today's session. All I have left is I finished my back downs on bench, and now all I have is accessories, and I'm not going to show the accessories. I think I'm going to pick back up on deadlifts on Monday.
Now, this may be an unpopular opinion, but I prefer the old AirPods over the new AirPods. But these seem to stay in my ear way better than the ones with the buds on them do. So that's just my take. But today, deadlifts, conventional. Hopefully we can do them. I'm not going to go back through the warm-ups. I'm just going to hop to the gym, get into the warm-ups of the actual deadlift. Already feeling it slightly. I think I'm gonna slow down my progression in warming up, so I'm not gonna go straight to another red. I'm just gonna go green and say, I don't know if it's because I'm like overthinking it that I'm feeling it, or if it's just that it's still a problem. But we're just gonna proceed forward with caution.
Let's go. You look good.
Got this.
Okay, so that went a lot better than I expected, honestly. Very minor pain, and I was really trying not to compensate to the other side of my legs, but very minor pain. It was like a 2 out of 10. So that's a big W for today, because last week I wasn't even able to deadlift, what, 485 for like one. So that's light years better than last week, and it'll probably get light years better next week. And then we should be back to normal. I could see next week being still kind of hesitant and light, but after that we should be back to the regular scheduled program as far as deadlifts. But now all I have is two back off sets, which I'll probably just take 418. And what sucks is, like, I thought coming in today, I thought like 418 would be like as high as I could go, because last session I couldn't even do 418. But what I was like embarrassed about was, like, I did a set of five with 418 on bench, and I had it like, that was like my top set the other day on deadlift, to put it in perspective of how like weak my deadlift is right now. But we just have two back off sets at that weight, and then some close grip bench, and hopefully we can push a little bit of weight on there, and then some dips for the accessories, and then I'll pretty much be it.
This is what he does between sets. He sits down and TikToks. So
yeah, it was a good day. I hit a PR on bench. I think I could do this for a living. That bitch has not benching anything. So yeah, what do you guys say? What do you guys say?
So what I was trying to do there warming up is, try to like fix my unrack, like get really tight on my upper body, and that way I could just extend my arms and have like an effortless unrack, which is a lot better, especially my top set, it moved pretty well. I would say that was like at a 7. It's still kind of like weird to get used to, especially with close grip. I feel like it'd feel a lot better with regular grip bench, but now I just have like 4 sets of 7, but I had to go down because I get fatigued quick when it comes to volume bench, so I'm gonna run these really quick, and then I'll probably show the dips, and then I'll be it. So let's get it. That for a quarter of the stack. And real quick, as I was editing the video, I thought it was really funny that my very last video was me saying like a whole video about how I'm switching to sumo, and now I'm like right back to conventional, so I just thought that was funny. But I think it's the most optimal choice for me right now. May switch back in the future, may not. Hopefully not. That was stressful, honestly. But
That's the end of the video. Thank you for watching. I'm trying to do at least one of these a week to document my training leading into Junior Nationals and then hopefully Junior Worlds. But yeah, appreciate you watching. Subscribe to see when the next video drops, and I'll see you on the next one.